So the first thing we need to do is get a Drupal 8 installation functional so that we can begin to work through the examples. So we're going to use Acquia Dev Desktop for this. This is an application that we've used in the past to set up a full Drupal environment along with the complete AMP stack. That's Apache, MySQL, PHP. If you decide to go this route as well, there's some introductory videos at the very beginning of the full list of videos on this site that walk you through how to install Acquia Dev Desktop on Windows or Mac. So we're not going to go through that here. We will go through the process of importing a site, but for more detail about this process, you can also look at some of those introductory videos. So I already have Acquia Dev Desktop open. And here in the background is the Drupal 8 snapshot inside of the Drupal 8 Development Prep Resource Pack. So if you haven't downloaded this already, you can get it off of buildamodule.com/resource-pack. Inside of this snapshot, if we expand it, we're going to see a folder called Drupal, and this is a full Drupal 8 install. And then we also have this about this version of Drupal 8 text file. If you open it, it will give you a little bit of information about when this snapshot was taken, the SHA, which is the hash that you can use to get this exact version from Git if you pull it from the Git repository, and some information on how to get this version of Drupal through Git. Now, it's likely that most of the work that we do in this Drupal 8 installation is not going to be portable to the version of Drupal 8 that eventually gets released. And that's okay because we're just doing some examples. But if you find yourself wanting to build out a full site or work on some modules that may be useful for you in the future, you may want to download the latest version of Drupal and work on that. By working on the snapshot of 8, we'll get around any frustration that might occur from inconsistencies with the videos, where you won't be able to make progress because of differences between this version and whatever the latest version of Drupal 8 is. Okay, I'm going to exit out of this. So with Dev Desktop, we can install Drupal anywhere on our hard drive. So we're going to go ahead and leave it in this Drupal 8 snapshot Drupal directory. So to import the Drupal 8 installation, we need to go to Settings, and then we need to go to Sites in the tabs, and then we need to click on Import. Here we need to browse to the file path where our Drupal directory is. So I'll go to the resource pack, I'll open up the snapshot, and I'll open up the Drupal folder, and then we'll click Open. This is a fresh installation, so we need to add a new database. So we'll select Create New Database, and for the database name, we'll put Drupal 8 Dev Prep. To make it easier to identify this site in our browser, let's go ahead and add a subdomain. We'll enter D8 Dev Prep and click Import. This will open up a browser to begin the installation process. We'll go ahead and select the language, English, and click Save and Continue. We'll leave it at the standard installation profile for now and click Save and Continue. The database name and the database username are both pre-filled, and we can just go ahead and click Save and Continue from here. And now it will install Drupal, and it will take just a few seconds. I'm going to fill these out real quick. Okay, so I entered Drupal 8 Dev Prep for the site name, and I entered my email address. Feel free to put whatever for yours. I'm creating a user called admin, but again, you can create whatever you'd like for this as well. I filled out the email address and password for the admin account. I set this to United States for the default country, and I'm going to uncheck the check for updates automatically. We know that we don't want to upgrade our Drupal 8 installation for this particular install. So I'll click Save and Continue. Okay, looks like everything went okay. Let's click Visit Your New Site. So this is the way that Drupal 8 should look after you install it. Now we're not going to go through many of the interface changes in this series. We're going to save that for a site building series later on. But if you've used Drupal before, this should look pretty familiar to you. We have a new toolbar across the top, and you see some editing icons here as we hover over various bits.